Let's head over to the Big 12, perhaps the wildest conference of the entire season. I saw on Twitter, I forget who posted it, I wish I could give them credit, but they basically posted the final Big 12 rankings relative to the preseason voting of the media members that went to Big 12 media days, and it is unbelievable how terrible they got this. I mean, how we got this.
Did like, anybody,
We did not have this Big 12 playing out, shaking out the way that it did. And we've you and I have talked about how good Kenny Dillingham is and how we are both bought in on Kenny Dillingham being a stud and a star as a coach and as a coordinator. He's been really good. But here he is against Matt Campbell, who, by the way, a program that's also hungry for a Big 12 championship. And are they just going to let Arizona State walk into the Big 12, you know, and just take a Big 12 championship for them, something that they've never accomplished themselves? I don't know. I think Matt Campbell's going to have those boys ready. I think Kenny Dillingham's going to have those boys ready. I think that this game is going to be awesome. And the matchups here are very, very interesting. You got Iowa State, which is a pretty balanced offense. Rocco Beck slinging the pill. You got some superstars. You got some really good athletes and speedsters at, you know, running back, at wide receiver, and at tight end. You also got a good talent there. I think you have a really solid offense there for Iowa State. Front seven that struggled this year, battled some injuries for Iowa State. You've given up a lot of yardage on the ground in multiple games. And Arizona State is just a team that is so well coached. They just come out in the first quarter and kick your teeth in and then let Brian Ward kind of unleash the dogs and just hold on for dear life. But Sam Leavitt has been one of the best quarterbacks in the entire country in terms of taking care of the football. All right, he's been unbelievably efficient as a redshirt freshman. At the running back spot, Cam Scadaboo has been ridiculous. Jordan Tyson, not that he came out of nowhere, right? But he kind of did. I mean, like, I didn't expect Jordan Tyson to be, like, over 1,000 yards, basically, for the season. Like, it happened the ridiculous year that he is. He has been unbelievable.
It sucks he's not going to play, though.
Yeah.
It is a big-time loss there, but you said it.
But like, you still have talent there at receiver. You still do.
I think that's the thing there. They're interesting. They're kind of like SMU in the fact that they just got a lot of guys. Not that they're all replaceable, but I think it's the way that they scheme things up and the bodies in that room there. I'm not too worried. Yeah, and you got some tight end depth there with Mateer kind of coming on as we're getting there. I look to the defense side here for Arizona State, and Welch and Abney and those two kids are very, very good defensively. They need to get after it because – you've got a couple very good receivers in Higgins for Iowa State and Noel, and they got Kansas State on third down when they needed spots there. They went to those two and they schemed things up and they really got it going. I will say this. I say this every time in our Iowa State videos, you have to run the football though. Iowa State, you have three running backs you like. Abu Sama has come on strong as of late. He had a really nice Farmageddon game. To me, he has to be a guy that you rely upon to get, you know, yardage, especially early in this game. You cannot go away from the run, even if Arizona State jumps on you. They have jumped on everybody since they've been really hot. They have just jumped out to great leads. And credit that coaching staff for having those players ready to play right away. But you see teams start to panic, and you see teams maybe start to fumble in that first half. And then they settle in the second half, and they stick to their game plan, and they get things going. To me, offensively, if you're Iowa State here, run the football. I love Rocco Beck. I love Noel. I love Higgins. I love all those guys. But to me, it's about running the football, controlling the clock, because you're damn sure know that Scadaboo, and that they're going to do that to you, right? Scadaboo, they're going to do that to you because he's a really good football player. Your run defense maybe is not quite what you wanted it to be coming into the season. And damn it, man. Arizona State's really good on offense, efficient. They're explosive. They do a lot of things that do hurt you. And if you go down early, you cannot abandon the run. Also, you want to take care of the football. Also, you don't want to give them short fields. And you also want to control time possession yourself. Do what they've done to so many Big 12 teams. Do it right back to them.
Yeah, I'm with you, dude. Arizona State, -2.5. I'll lay it.
Yeah.
Okay. I like them in this spot. I really do. Like you said, getting the early start and then letting Brian Ward do his thing. And I think And from a run defense perspective, I mean, Arizona State's been solid. You know, if Iowa State does try to run the ball early, I fear that they will abandon the run. I fear that they will. If Arizona State gets up early like they love doing, I have a fear that they will abandon the run. But that also leaves, you know, a lot of points on the table potentially. Which, we'll go to the counter later and we'll see what I like in this game. But I'm liking multiple angles here. So, yeah. You're laying 2.5, I'm assuming. Is that what you said?
Yeah, I'm with you here. Is we picking at 2.5?
2.5, yeah.
There are twos out there, though, right?
Oh, yeah.
Friendly reminder, if you like to gamble, if you like to or at least you dabble in that stuff, always shop lines because we're picking at 2.5 because we like to half. We don't like to push. And I think it kind of tests us a little bit more and see where we're really at, make us firm in our conviction, pick a winner as well. But Iowa State, too, last thing here, not only are they not like good rushing the ball, but like what Arizona State does so well is like chunk plays through the ground. Right, and Iowa State is 15th out of 16 teams in the Big 12 and giving up 10-plus yard rushes. The only one that's worse is Oklahoma State, who is well worse than everybody else. That's not in the spot that you want to be grouped with them defensively this year.
No, not at all.